The following is a stereo presentation of WYES-TV, New Orleans. Funding for this program is made possible by the Louisiana Endowment for the Humanities, a state affiliate of the National Endowment for the Humanities. Additional funding is provided by the Louisiana Division of the Arts and the National Endowment for the Arts, and by Bookstar, supporting information in all its forms and helping to bring you the best on public television.
New Orleans, the Creole city. The Creole label has been popular for years and shows no signs of disappearing. Neither does the controversy over what Creole really means, especially when Creole people are involved.
It means what the person who uses it thinks it means, and the person who receives it accepts as that meaning. And certainly, let us say, in my household when I was a child, oh, c'est une vieille Creole meant purely and simply she's a white woman of French language born in Louisiana.
I call myself a person of Creole descent because of my knowledge of my family history and the people, as far back as I can trace, who called themselves Creoles.
Well, Webster defined the Creole as anyone living in New Orleans and Louisiana. I don't know, that's very vague, I think, but I think the definition of the Creole is of French and Spanish and Negro blood. I think that would be my definition of Creole.
Hello, I'm Peggy Scott Laborde at the Herman Grima House in the French Quarter, the home of two early Creole families of New Orleans. We've all heard the meaning of Creole debated dozens of times with little agreement. Join us as we take a look at what we call the Creole Controversy. Most frequently asked questions in New Orleans history is what does the term Creole mean? And that question is so caught up in our unique past that it's hard to understand one without considering the other. Argued about at home, Creoles are an even greater mystery to most outsiders, whose attempts to portray them usually add to the existing confusion. In a typical film of the early 1920s, Creoles are seen as quaint residents of the French Quarter, possessing a required mix of Spanish and French ancestry, and living in a romantic world right out of the 19th century. Then there are the academic definitions of the term, which describe Creoles as New World descendants of Old World ancestry. But in popular New Orleans usage, meanings are much more specific, and often conflicting. Understanding this conflict requires a broad approach.
Well, one has to recognize that that language is a functional thing. It's a consensus among those who use it. And so that a term has no absolute inflexible, some sort of spiritual meaning that is beyond the ability of those who use the language to change. And so what we find frequently, and essentially, it's essentially true here, that Creole is going to be understood differently by different people at different times and different places.
Language evolves, and in New Orleans, Creole has come to mean different things to different people. New Orleans' 6th and 7th wards were a traditional Creole neighborhood. But today, the younger generation has moved away, and the racial and ethnic character of the community has changed. Older religious traditions and memories of earlier life there still linger, along with firm beliefs regarding Creole identity.
To me, a Creole is someone who's racially mixed and who lives here in New Orleans or South Louisiana, whose family has been here a very long time, whose family was probably of, you know, who's a descendant of either a French or a Spanish family. And I think my personal definition stresses the fact of someone being racially mixed. You know, the textbook definition, theoretically, is someone or something native to the New World. Emotionally, my definition doesn't square with the textbook definitions.
The main issue in the Creole controversy today is the question of race. There are whites who call themselves Creoles, there are blacks who call themselves Creoles, and there are mixed-race Creoles. In many cases, those of one group refuse to recognize the others, or are simply unaware of their existence.
When I was growing up, the only definition that we had, the only definition that we used, the only way we used the word was to describe someone who was racially mixed. And if someone would have told me, you know, 20 years ago, that there was such a thing as a white Creole or a black Creole, I would have said, oh, you're kidding, there is no such thing as a black or a white Creole. You know, Creoles are only racially mixed people. And again, that has nothing to do with the textbook definition of the term. That's the way we use it. And I think if you talk to people right now and ask them what a Creole is, people from New Orleans, that's the definition that they will give you.
But not everyone agrees with that definition. A popular alternative includes the requirement of some French or Spanish ancestry, and sometimes both. Whether racial ancestry is also important depends upon the beliefs of the person using the term. In this version of Creole, it is French heritage that is emphasized, and New Orleans is remembered as a city of French language and culture, a city where for some, Creole has come to mean French Creole.
Well, today is our celebration of Bastille Day. It's a three-day celebration this year in honor of the bicentennial of the French Revolution, and this is one of the means of perpetuating our French customs, our French tradition, our French food that has made New Orleans what it is today. Not only my own view, but Webster's Dictionary speaks of a Creole of anybody of French or Spanish descent born in Louisiana. And locally, I think, it has generally meant those of French background, but anybody of French or Spanish background should be the accepted definition of what a Creole actually is. And incidentally, the French predominated. Whenever there was intermarrying of French and Spanish families, the language and the customs were overridden by the French background.
Yes, a Creole for me, in New Orleans that is someone of French and Spanish descent. Because of the early colonists, the French were here first and then the Spanish. There are certainly different definitions of Creole, but I think in New Orleans, it's definitely someone of French and Spanish descent.
Again, not everyone would agree, including people throughout South Louisiana who speak the Creole dialect that developed in colonial times. Through constant daily contact between those who spoke African languages and those who spoke French.
One of the ways that I arrived at a definition of Creole was from the neighborhood in which I grew up and my personal experiences. Before I read anybody's definition, I was growing up in a neighborhood where there were people who were identified by themselves and by other people in the community as Creoles. And I arrived at what a Creole was by what I saw about me. I was not growing up in the Seventh Ward. I was growing up in a neighborhood that's called Uptown New Orleans, and that had a lot of people who had migrated from small towns, some in Louisiana, some in Mississippi, and there was a grocery store on one of the corners that was operated by a succession of people who called themselves Creoles. These people were white. I heard Creole spoken in the grocery store daily. in conversations between whites and blacks who also called themselves Creoles, my mother included. So I immediately decided that Creole was not necessarily black only, was not necessarily white only. One of the things that the people seemed to have in common was that their families had been in Louisiana somewhere a long time. And another thing was that they tended to be Catholic.
Today, many descendants of those white families have dropped the Creole label, especially outside New Orleans, where Creole now mainly refers to French-speaking blacks. And within the black community, there is disagreement as to whether skin color, status, and class background have any place in Creole identity or in contemporary black identity. What Creole has come to mean today clearly varies, with some groups claiming that theirs is the true meaning, that Louisiana Creoles have only one set of racial or ethnic or even cultural characteristics. One approach to the controversy is to look to Louisiana's past to see how the word was used here in earlier times and how that use changed. Origins of the term go back to the time of European colonial settlement in the 16th, 17th, and 18th centuries, when a number of Creole societies and Creole languages developed around the world. Linguists say the English word Creole comes from the French word Creole. The Spanish term criollo was used even earlier, derived from a verb meaning to raise or to breed. Criollo was used to distinguish people born in the Spanish colonies from both the native Indian population and from those in the colony who had come from Europe or Africa. The Portuguese had a similar term in their colonies. Both the Spanish and Portuguese made extensive use of the Creole designation in their slave trade, with Creole slaves valued for their acquired resistance to disease and their ability to speak the Creole dialect. In South America, whites eventually reserved the term for themselves and their offspring, but this limitation in usage was by no means universal.
It seems fairly clear that, and certainly the documentary evidence is there, that in the Caribbean islands particularly, the term was used specifically for one purpose only, and that was to distinguish those native to the region as against those who were not, with no respect to race, color, status, anything of the sort. If you were born in the islands, you were Creole. If you were not born in the islands, you were not Creole. It was simple as that. And it, again, is almost positive that that was the usage that was brought into Louisiana in the early colonial period.
Written records support this theory that in early Louisiana, Creole was a descriptive term primarily indicating native Louisiana birth. It was used most frequently in reference to slaves. Broad application to people of differing race, color, ethnic ancestry, and social status, both slave and free, becomes obvious in the antebellum or pre-Civil War period, after Louisiana became part of the United States. Historians have compiled a long list of citations showing use of the word in newspapers, advertisements, legal records, private letters, and other written documents, sources that show how the term was used in everyday life. That blacks could be Creoles is shown in newspaper ads like this one from 1828, printed in both French and English.
Mrs. Plantevine, being about to depart for France, desires to sell the following servants, all Creoles of this city.
Or another from the same year.
Wanted to purchase a seamstress who can also wash and iron. She must be a Creole or acclimated.
Other citations show that the term was also used by free blacks, or free persons of color, as they were called, many of whom were of mixed racial ancestry and thoroughly French in language and culture. Again, native Louisiana birth is a logical interpretation of Creole, as shown in this 1827 French will.
I am Louis Helene, son of Helene Poiret, free woman of color. I am a Creole of New Orleans.
Descriptive accounts of New Orleans written in the 1840s and 50s comment on Creole ethnic ancestry as well as native birth.
Society is made up of a mixture of almost all nations. First and foremost is the Creole population. All who are born here come under this designation without reference to the birthplace of their parents.
Other accounts were more direct.
Understand, good reader, that Creole is a word signifying native,
and applies to all kinds of men and things indigenous.